Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Eden streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth series. Thank you everybody who noticed the new thumbnails, by the way. I figured it was time for a new coat of paint, and why not? 38 wins, still going strong here, hopefully anyway. Let's hope for a good start. No whammy, stop. Pandora's Box and the Wafer, along with the pill. Here's your seed day. It's going to be Romeo, Foxtrot, Victor, November, Kilo, Bravo, 2, Hotel. Terrible speed, terrible tears rate. Decent damage, it looks like, but we also have Pandora's Box. Now, the thing about Pandora's Box is, and excuse me while I, again, go for a little bit of a Cliff Notes version here for Isaac, but the neat thing about Pandora's Box, especially starting with it early, is that you can kind of manipulate how you want it to pay out for you. What I mean by that is that Pandora's Box is a space bar item that you can use as a one-time only use. That will produce you certain items or different items depending on what floor you are on. There's a tendon rock up there, by the way. So basically the first floor, you can get 2 soul hearts, which is not too bad. Second floor, you get 2 keys, 2 bombs. I act like I'm like able to recite this by heart, but in reality, I actually have it on my second monitor. I'm not going to try to act like I'm cheating or anything like, or like I'm like the end all be all of Isaac here. I'm interested in possibly using it for soul hearts here, especially since that first tenant rock didn't give us a key, and by key I mean bomb. But with the Satanic Bible, that just pretty much made up my mind. So thank you Pandora's Box for the extra 2 soul hearts. I really do appreciate it. And we've got ourselves very 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 strong start here with the Satanic Bible. Of course, it's one of the best items that you could ever hope for in your literal first starting item room. Gives you a black soul heart after 6 runes, and of course that is going to pretty much solidify our deal with the devil chances, thereby solidifying a very good start here for this run. And surprisingly, our tears rate does not seem to match what the stats page has to offer here, which is not really all that unheard of. The stats page in Isaac has been known to be somewhat, let's just say, ambiguous in nature when it comes to actually showing you what your stats are versus what the game truly thinks your stats should be anyway. And use this golden key, and we end up getting an eternal heart along with another bomb, which of course now I'm going to take this bomb and blow up this tinted rock, and we get yet another golden chest. Fantastic game, appreciate that. Of course, I would have loved to have gone and used that bomb for those coins there. We did get another soul heart, so it's not going to hurt us. You know what? Why not? Why not take a balls of steel pill? Sure, you know, it's a 40-hour energy. Cool. That's, that's a good thing. And after 1 minute and 55 seconds, we're sitting at 11.5 HP. If you want to include our eternal heart, that's going to be a full rack of hearts literally on stage 1. So I'm not saying this is a one run or anything like that, but we have literally no excuse to lose this run. I can't complain because it was, we had terrible HP. Yeah, it literally cannot get any better than this start for an Eden run, especially when we have the Wafer, which essentially doubles our HP going into the womb and higher, because normally basic attacks from enemies, or actually any attacks from enemies, will usually deal 1 full heart of damage regardless of the type of heart. Oh my goodness, another Tinted Rock. Irregardless of the type of heart that we currently have in our possession at the present time as of right now. But with the Wafer, that's going to turn that and basically make it to where it's always going to count as a half heart, thereby doubling the amount of HP. So instead of 12 hits, assume we had a maximum rack of HP, 6 on top, 6 on bottom, we can take 24 hits until we die. And it should not ever take anyone of any playstyle, at least with the amount of experience I have in this game, 24 hits in order to possibly lose a run. At least not in the same room, anyway. We got Headless Horseman, which is an interesting proposition here, because the Headless Horseman kind of, that was pretty bad. The Headless Horseman kind of alleviates a little bit of a concern, which is our terrible movement speed. Also, of course, if we had the Headless Horseman's horse, we would indeed have the Flying Pony. And for those of you who do recall, having early flying is extremely helpful. And also, keep in mind that with flying here, depending on whether or not I decide to go with the Satanic Bible, which I probably still will because that's a guaranteed win, the flying pony will give us all that money in the room before the curse room, or at least the room before the room with the curse. Look, you know which one I'm talking about. That was not a good amount of damage there, so taking a little bit of dumb damage, that's okay. We get the flying pony, and you see how much of a difference our movement speed is. Yeah, I really really wish we had more bombs. I had forgotten about this room, but I'm glad that I had made that quip. Really surprised the secret room's not there. Really surprised the secret room's not there. There's something off about this. This screams secret room. I can't believe that. I would have lost if I would have if I were a betting man, which I'm not because I'm not good at gambling. But if I were, I would have bet the house that the secret room was right there. It has to be above the item room at this point. That's the only thing I can think of. Which would be nice because then, of course, that would give us access to getting into the shop. This also kind of looks like a secret room. Yeah, okay. This is going to be the regular secret room. But unfortunately now this means that we have no access to our shop. It really shouldn't take us 5 minutes to get through the first floor here with this start. But since we have flying, I'm at least going to check other things. Okay, so we've already done a full clear. Fair enough. So we're going to leave here with a whole lot of HP. Good stats. We've got, we have 3 bombs. Not really the best as far as utility goes, but we do have 20 cents. I'm going to say goodbye to the Flying Pony. It's been a lovely trip. But unfortunately, I can't pass up a free win here, especially as we are now approaching 1 win away from 40. Now, I don't want to get ahead of myself. In the past, I did make a pact at some point, no pun intended. I did make a pact to say, you know, I'm going to stop saying everything's a one run because that's when we get complacent, and when you get complacent, you get comfortable. When you get comfortable, that's when you start getting sloppy, and I don't want to do that. So all I will say is that it is going to take an amazing amount of damage or a Curse of the Blind reroll, like say, for example, if we end up touching Missing No, which is very, very rare, but the only time that would ever happen would be on a Curse of the Blind, because I otherwise would never, ever take that. Barring something like that, this run is almost unlosable. And depending on when we get here for this Deal with the Devil, which again, by the way, this is only floor two. I realize that, you know, we're 5.5 minutes here. Oh my goodness. I did not mean to drop a bomb there, but apparently Isaac got more startled than I did. There's our key. I think we should actually use this key to go into the shop. As counterintuitive as that may seem, especially due to the fact that we have not been in our item room, I'd rather buy something early here. Since we do have 20 cents, it's kind of a godsend. Again, no pun intended there. And yeah, there's a mosquito. I see you. He's running away. I've got my eye on you, mosquito. Don't think you're public enemy number one here. There's no love for mosquitoes ever anywhere. I'm actually allergic to mosquito bites. Well, most insect bites in general. And bites. Their bites also get me pretty allergic. Not really too concerned about that. I was really actually hoping for a blood bank so we could get rid of this red heart. And red heart HP, that is. And, you know, hopefully get, like, I don't know, some more money that we can spend in the store, which I haven't found yet. We got another key, which is going to make my decision easy. And we're going to go back to the Yieldy item room. And after, of course, walking into a fire that should never, ever be next to a door, but for some reason is. I'm also going to open up that tinted rock back down there. I'm going to use one bond. Little Chub is not really needed. Little Haunt's even less needed. You know what? No, I'm not making a decision to take Little Haunt, by the way. I was willing to spend up to 5 cents to reroll him. Little Haunt's one of those items I usually never take, just because they cause more harm than good. Oh my goodness, another tinted rock. How many tinted rocks is that? This has to be a record for the amount of tinted rocks that we've had in 2 floors. We're taking, by the way, ridiculous amounts of terrible damage. Not really, not yet to the point of that cursed eye run that we had. Oh man. This is just getting outrageous. Like, if you looked at our current build and the items that we have, minus our trinket, you would probably have assumed that, like, okay, we probably had, like, a rough go, but, like, you know, now we're starting to get on the upswing here. No, no, no. This is floor two, man. Or woman out there. This is, like ridiculous good starts. And, yeah, I'm taking really bonehead damage, but honestly, part of that is due to us having to wait for the other parts, just me just kind of defiantly not even worrying about dodging, because I mean, let's be honest, it's going to be almost near impossible for the game to kill me again, barring the oh God. And yes, I should have taken Diplopia there. That was a really dumb play, but yeah, especially the fact that we now have the ultimate combo of Sackhead along with the Satanic Bible. There is no way In no way in a million guppy lives that I would ever, ever lose this. I'm looking for that mosquito. Now I'm paranoid. We even get a crawl space with scatter bombs. Now, scatter bombs is not usually an item that I'm too high on. I will take it because we do kind of need bombs right now. But scatter bombs traditionally is not really that great of an item. And we got Monstro. For some reason, the space bar was not working there. I'm not sure why. Do we need to use bombs here? No. But I might as well, just because it's just going to speed things up. We are running like way behind, especially given that the speed that we were currently maybe sometime in the near future be moving at. But with flying now, I think we're just going to go down the next floor. I don't even care about that soul heart, honestly. What do we need on a run like this? Damage. Damage, damage, damage. We locked in the deal with the devil. We're starting to catch back up. Curse of Lost is going to slow us down a little bit. But damage is a big thing. Our damage isn't bad right now. It could be a lot better, though. If we want to keep up this momentum that we've got going in this run, then damage is going to be ideal. Honestly, even if we end up getting no damage upgrade for the rest of this run, which would be absolute hell, by the way, but if that ended up happening, we could still probably win this. I refuse to believe that actually hit us. I saw that shot hit the wall, and I guess it hit us. I'm like really paranoid now. I'm like looking at my legs and stuff. I'm just gonna get super duper lazy about this. I've been having like this. I don't know. Like it feels like I'm being eaten by ants every single time I go to bed and like try to get some sleep. It's actually affecting my sleep a little bit lately, and I don't know why. Like I will like every now and then like I'll have like a little red bump, but it's not like a. I don't know, it's not like a insect bite, it's just like a, I don't know, just a little red bump, that's all I can say. Yes, this is story time, by the way. Let's learn uncomfortable amounts of information about Syndicta. Okay. So, in order for you to understand where I'm sort of stumbling to get to here, as far as my conclusion goes, whenever you get like a bite, like an insect bite, you'll like start getting paranoid and be like, oh man, you know, I really feel like there's ants all over me, and there's actually nothing there. But it all kind of stems from that initial bite that you think you had. Yeah, that's the kind of thing that like has been keeping me up for the past couple of days here. By the way, yeah, I probably should have mentioned that because of Sackhead and the Head of the Keeper, we also can spawn our own sacks here. So you know, good on us that. And yes, I am running into. I'm literally using our black hearts as weapons here. Because honestly, there's no reason not to. The wafer, ironically, the wafer is actually going to slow this strat down a little bit. But you probably have never seen a run like this go this way. And I'm not trying to say that I'm bringing some sort of, you know, sexy back, you know, meta-defining strategy here. I'm just saying that with the Satanic Bible and on top of that Sackhead, we're not going to run out of HP. And you know, if our shot damage was a little bit better, I wouldn't even have to worry about this, but honestly our shot damage is pretty poor. And yeah, it's just going to, you know, continue our sort of feels bad man. I did it again. I'm not good at memeing. I'm not a meme lord like Dan. I'm not even half a meme lord Dan is. That's like, you just don't even joke about that, man. Like if you think you're a meme lord, you're not. Alright, Dan Giesling's got it down. He's perfected it. I mean, like, the only person in our circle of friends that I would say is even in the same ballpark, but, like, not, like, in the same, like, he's not in the same, like, dugout slash, like, infield. Like, he's, like, he's parking his car in of the same field as Rob. If there's one person who's somewhat in the same ballpark in the broken analogy that I just got done using, as Dan, as far as memes is concerned, it's definitely going to be Rob. Rob's got a little bit of the art down. He hasn't got all of it down, though. But he is, he's a meme lord in training, that's for sure. You can't deny the talent. This is ridiculous. and we got a Joker card, too. I mean, the Joker card's going to be good. We need some good stuff on this run. I'll use the Box of Secrets just because, I guess. Obviously, we're going to take the Joker card. Now, what would I give up the Satanic Bible for? Probably blank card Joker. But you're going to have to really kind of... That's a hard sell to make, man. If you try to sell me off of this ridiculous strat that we have right now. And by the way, this is the ultra... This is seriously like the epitome of laziness in Afterbirth. Just purposely taking damage just so we can trigger our black soul hearts. Like, what a first world Isaac problem. Oh, man, we got no damage. I guess I better just use my infinite black soul hearts here to cause damage. Oh, man, this is... Honestly, it's the game's fault, really. I mean, I'm not gonna take the blame for this one, game. You put me in this terrible, terrible situation I'm in with no damage. How could you? I'm waiting for our comeuppance, though. I definitely am expecting the bad start to happen soon. Although, to be fair, I've had my fair share of bad starts on this streak so far. And, you know, getting one like this, I'm not gonna complain. Not at all. I'm not gonna take any of these pills that I don't know, because honestly, the only one I would even care about would be either Tears Up or Balls of Steel. It's gonna be Krampus, which is fine by me. The reason why this is fine is just basically because I don't have to worry about paying the Krampus tax later. We still retain our Joker card without having to use it. And honestly, usually more times than not, you'll end up spawning Krampus just due to you forcing a deal with the devil on a floor that you didn't earn it or that you shouldn't have gotten. And normally that will trigger Krampus. So, you know, getting rid of the Krampus tax here early is fine. Didn't get Lump of Coal, that's fine too. I'm not even going to entertain the thought of picking up Krampus. You know what, I'm just going to go down to the next floor. Yeah, it's a good run. We're again, surprisingly slow. Curse of the Unknown. The answer is everything. The answer is we don't worry about HP on this run game. Blind Rage. I mean, Blind Rage is maybe debatably on par with... Safety Scissor, by the way, Blind Rage will give you an extended period of invulnerability after taking a hit. Meaning that, you know, if you do actually take a hit, it's not going to hurt you that bad because you're going to have like an extra couple seconds to get safe again. So many Lover's cards, I'm not sure what's up with that. And I'm just going to keep on going here. I'm going to be a little bit more cautious with my HP with Curse of the Unknown, obviously, but again, it doesn't matter. We can spawn our own sacks, man. We can get as much HP as we want. We just have to not take damage. There's actually a library here, too, which I think is a library anyway. No, it's a reroll room. So this is a two room, and the two room will reroll everything that's on the ground in this current room only. So one pill, and we'll turn that into a golden chest, which turned out to be sacks. And we got a bunch of keys, and an Algis room, which I am... Needless to say, not interested in, but I appreciate the thought, game. You have been kind of working me over on this run, not gonna lie. I'm just gonna get rid of this song and dance real quick. Again, epitome of super laziness, super non-optimal, but I figure why not get a little creative with our next Isaac run today? Why not just cause a whole lot of damage to ourselves, not care about high score, and show how ridiculous the Satanic Bible can be? Especially with us, with Sackhead. Now, something to keep in mind as well. Just imagine, if I didn't take, or if I didn't save the Satanic Bible, we wouldn't be able to do this. This is like art that you're seeing right here. I'm not going to try to call myself an artist. I'm certainly far from it. However, we're getting a little creative here with this offensive strategy. This is honestly the first time I've ever done this as well. So this is a kind of a learning experience. You know, I'm trying to keep my one good eye open for that mosquito, and then the other side I'm also trying to, like, you know, not take red heart damage, which is going to be almost virtually impossible, although I have, to be quite honest, no idea how much HP we have right now, thanks to Curse the Unknown. And we're not getting our full charges, game. I don't know, I'm gonna have to send this run back to the store. I think I'm gonna demand a Steam refund for this run. What a god awful run this has been. I mean, you didn't give me my battery charge, game, when I needed it most. Where are you? What kind of service am I paying you, not paying you for? That was a really good bomb, by the way. That was a really good bomb. Scatter bomb, I'm impressed. Normally, the little bombs don't normally make this much damage. Like, I believe is divided by how many bombs split, which I think is, like, they usually do 25% of the original bomb. This has not been bad. Alright, we did not get a deal with the devil, so I am going to use this Joker card. World card, at least in these braces. We'll go ahead and use this now, and we get Goathead and a contract from below. If you thought that we, were getting a lot of batteries before, oh boy. You ain't seen nothing yet, Darla. I don't even know who Darla is, but you ain't seen nothing yet, Darla. Are we going to make boss rush? No. Do we care? No. We don't. Absolutely don't care. And yeah, we'll just get the mine because I went ahead and get more ahead. If there's one thing we needed was mapping so we could effectively plan out our super secret rooms. I'm just looking for ye olde full charges here. There's one. And there's another. Let's play guess how much HP Invicta has after the end of this floor. I'm gonna say 7. I'm gonna say 7 HP total once we leave this floor. Yes, I am moving into these shots on purpose, by the way, in case you just thought I was literally the worst Isaac player of all time. I am, but I'm not that bad. So yeah, we're still not even on red hearts right now. Oh man. By the way, the mind is going to show us the entire map, so including super secret rooms and regular secret rooms, which is very good. Now, wouldn't it be fun if we actually got the golden teleporter? That's another ultimate wombo combo dream combo in Isaac, is getting the mind and then the golden teleporter. You talk about free IMR rooms for the rest of your days. Yeah, you are guaranteed to get it. Well, is obviously assuming that you have the full charges, so. If we had the golden teleporter right now, this would literally be the most perfect situation to have that on. And it's been showing up a lot. Would I take the golden teleporter of the Satanic Bible? Yeah, I probably would, just for the zaniness of it all. I mean, we had sort of a pseudo-failed run on stream last week. At the time of this recording, anyway. When this goes up, it'd probably be 2 weeks ago. Where I had the golden teleporter, and then I accidentally like went to the mom fight without realizing that like I didn't have a full charge, so I didn't get the Iamera room, which meant that I couldn't get the extra item, which made everybody very, very sad. 2 nickels, sure. And I'm just gonna go to the next floor. Look, it's a strong run, but not for the reasons that you would think. It's not strong because we've got an incredible amount of damage. It's just the amount of utility that we have on this run is absolutely ridiculous. It's incredibly ridiculous. And I'm not going to feel sorry for it one bit because you know that it's coming. By the way, I said 7. We actually had 6, so I was close. On our total leaving HP, by the way. For those of you who might have short-term memory loss, like I do, I mean, that's fine. I'm actually, like, I'm still looking out for this mosquito. The fact that it's in my bedroom is also really bad. Like, I'm gonna hunt this fool down as soon as we're done with this. The world. Thank God we got that world card. I was a little bit lost. I don't really need that. It's a little bit of a waste of time. Let's go check out this curse room here. This run would be a little bit faster, obviously, if we just had really any decent damage. Yeah, I wanted to spawn two hosts. That's fine. I think the ghost is still alive, too, yeah. Isn't that a weird statement? If we gotta do this the hard way, I'm willing to. Do I want to? No. But I will. Yeah, no, I didn't mean to do that, but I'm glad I did, I guess. Alright, we got that one Book of Belial shot off. And there's a Demon Judgment here, which I will obviously be going pretty darn hard on. Yeah, that came out exactly the way that I wanted to say it. Why? Well, because we've got the wafer, and we don't have to worry about HP ever. Ever. So, Mom's Bottle of Pills, I mean, just, tacking on the list of stuff that nobody asked for in this run. I really, really, really wish that I could just get give me one damage item. That's all I really want. So I don't have to keep employing this ridiculous strategy of just using my black hearts over and over again just to clear basic rooms, man. What would be my ultimate get right now? Something like Ipecac or Mom's Knife. Would I take Brimstone? Of course I would, but I would actually prefer Mom's Knife over Brimstone in this situation, because we, with the lack of damage items that we have not gotten on this run, yeah, that's a waste of a full charge, and that's fine. We don't, again, we don't need it. But yeah, with the lack of damage upgrades that we have in this run, Brimstone would actually be not an ideal choice. We obviously would be clearing stuff a lot faster. I mean, anything would be faster than how we're clearing right now, but yeah, Mom's Knife would at least alleviate a lot of our damage concerns, which are slim to none, because I don't really have concerns about this run, but, actually, you know what, I'm going to take the Fool card, or the High Priestess card here. Happy to see no there. Every empty room is like a small victory here that we don't have to really worry about taking 10 minutes to do. I realize that there is almost no reason for me to be complaining about a run like this, but you see our damage. You can't deny that our damage is a little bit of the Garbo tier, which is kind of the... I'm really happy actually that I picked up multidimensional baby. I mean, we can't even like stay away from these claiming fast enough before we can't, before they respawn, like we can't kill them fast enough. So I meant to say. Sun card is literally useless. I will take the mulligan. If not only to hopefully boost our DPS just by a little bit. And it really is not that much, because we don't have a good base amount of stats here as far as tiers, or as far as our tier damage is concerned. So we get another sack over here. It's gonna give us another bomb and a coin. Justice did not give us a didn't actually give us a full charge. That was an amazing... You know what? That keeper deserves to live. I'm not even gonna try to explain that one. Well, that's good. At least they made, you know, one host and then turned it into several, and then we actually somewhat accidentally blew them all away there. So Ansa's rune, I mean, thank God. Again, I was really, you know, lost on this run. So we know this shop's gonna be good because we fought a mini boss. Yeah, stopwatch. This run's goofy, but I don't want to get like, yeah, I don't want to get super boring with this run. It's already somewhat boring, not in a bad way boring. I mean, anything that's boring is a bad sort of deal, because you could be doing a lot more creative stuff with your time. But this is we would be going a lot faster if we just had a damage upgrade. I mean, Head of the Keeper, you know, I appreciate everything, but you're not a good damage upgrade. In fact, I don't even think you are a damage upgrade. Death card, I'm going to hold on to the High Priestess just because it is damage, and we're just going to get more pills because we needed them. I don't know why we keep getting so many gosh dang pills on this run, but... Gish. Alright, did half damage, is fine. Hoping something really good here in this deal with double. Yes, our life is getting slightly low here. Am I worried? No. Not at all. You know why? Because that right there. Because we can spawn our own sacks, man. All I gotta do is just hit something. I can hit rocks. I can hit a wall and just respawn it back. Am I going to do that? No. If the streak was in danger, yes. I would probably go that crazy. I would also probably cut the video. But yeah, we don't need to do that. Now this run, admittedly, this floor is going to hurt a little bit, assuming that we do get a deal with the devil and not like three red chests in the deal with the devil room. Just because we don't have enough red hearts to facilitate taking, you know, two cheap deals with the devil. So we are going to be, at the very worst, down to 2 HP at the end of this floor. Assuming I don't take any more hits from Gish here. And again, you see how terrible our damage is, because, yeah, that took quite a long time. No full charge. Well, Gish, he's going to help out a little bit, of course. No full charge. Blank rune was a Yara rune. And we get the Book of Sin and Headless Baby. Obviously, neither one of these are worth taking, so we're just going to go down the next floor with our very low damage and not else. Yes, I'm still looking for that stupid mosquito. I have a feeling he probably bit me already at some point. And oh man, you talk about the reckoning. He's gonna get his as soon as I find him. Come on, Mulligan. By the way, the Mulligan will give us a chance to spawn a fly every time we land a shot on an enemy. It's very similar to the base effect of Guppy, except obviously if we prefer a little bit more damage coming out of our Mulligan shots. And honestly, I'm surprised we haven't been seeing more full charges. A little disappointed, I'm gonna be honest. At the end of every floor, we should just be having, like, you know, full HP. I should be able to push a button and just win the run. Why doesn't anyone do that anymore? The glory days of Game Genie. Ask and you shall appear. Well, we got one. I'm not going to waste that one, let's put it that way. I will use the Sun Card just to kill these two jerks in here. Yeah, I don't really care about the Matchstick. Matchstick's going to give our chance to increase, or at least increase our chances of getting bombs. Moon Card, let's go ahead and take. We'll come back and get the Joker card in a second. So yeah, if you asked, you know, why am I not worried about our rapidly declining health, that's why. Because the game's giving us plenty of opportunities to stay alive here. Not even including the, you know, the fact that we do have Sackhead and the Satanic Bible. In case you didn't notice, we have that combo. Not sure if you did or not. It's probably worth us taking a look in the, taking a look inside of the boss trap room. Is it worth it to waste a Joker card just so you don't have to do the boss trap room? Probably not, because we're basically throwing away our chance of ever getting a deal with the devil on the cathedral. But I don't care. Yeah, so that was not even worth it. We get Maw of the Void, which is fantastic. As if we needed another way to create Black Soul Hearts for us. We just got another one. And, you know, Maw of the Void, it's going to help out our lack of damage thereof. Of course, our charge time is going to be horrendous because our tears rate's just god awful. But yeah, it's something. It's damage. We can sort of kamikaze into anything that we want. To a spades. I mean, yeah, you know, we'll just take another soul heart. That's fine too. It's my Curly doing the garden impression. Who's Curly? Like you kids and your not knowins the 1920s and 1940s smash comedic group, the Three Stooges. Love the Three Stooges. Curly was always my favorite. I also liked Moe because Moe was, like, always somewhat in charge. But Curly, let's be honest. Everyone loved... if you didn't love Curly, there was something wrong with you. No, I ain't no Shemp. I don't need none of these Shemp apologists in here either. Shemp had his moments for sure, but he's no Curly. Come on. I'll never forget, I think I actually mentioned this in a Isaac episode too, weirdly enough. There's a very rare clip of all four of the brothers. Curly, Shemp, Moe, and Larry, literally all in the same room. And it's the only time it's ever happened. And it was already after Curly had said his goodbyes to the Stooges and everything. And he's basically a passenger on a I think he's on a, like an airplane. It might be on a train or something. And you know, he does the whole dog barking thing, and everyone, you know, it was a rare opportunity to see all four of them in the same room. You can find that clip on YouTube. I don't remember the exact name of it, but I think they basically say, you know, what was that? And I think Mo or Larry, one of them says, like, it sounded like a cocker spaniel or something, you know, because Curly was doing his dog barking bit. Another thing that's cool about that clip is that Curly actually has hair. Like, you rarely ever, if ever, have seen Curly with a full head of hair. And he actually does have that in clip, which is the coolest part about that clip, by the way. This is what happens when we get a somewhat slow-moving Isaac run here that we can't lose. Start talking about the Three Stooges, and that's not a bad thing at all. I will happily rap about the Stooges, man. If you weren't down with the Three Stooges, then the only thing else I can think that you may have been down with in those days were probably maybe close to Martin and Lewis, but let's be honest, the Three Stooges were way before Martin and Lewis. I mean, way before. Stick to God, how old are you? I'm like 90, dude. Like, I'm like somewhere around there. Look at Guppy's head. Guppy's head's pretty good. It's no infinite HP Satanic Bible, but you know, it's good. It's a Guppy item. You know, we're just... just so we can round out our HP. They're not all black soul hearts yet. We gotta get it going. We have priorities. Yeah, we'll take infamy too. Why not? I mean, I guess I probably could be using, like, you know, Guppy's head whenever we go over a full charge right now, just to make more flies. I'm down with that. I can't really complain about the lack of damage here if I'm not willing to go the full lengths of optimizing our strategies here with full charges. And even if somehow we ran out of full charges, Guppy and somehow lost the Satanic Bible, Guppy's head is still gonna be pretty much a GG just because of the simple fact that you know, we have the wafer. The wafer is the absolute premier carry support item in the game. I truly mean that. Curse the tower. I don't believe that the tower bombs actually inherit the scatter bomb trait. I don't think so. I'm 90% sure that they don't. Let's find out. They do. The 10% one. What is this, Darkest Dungeon? We just don't care about damage. We're rolling thunder here. That might be damage. I mean, we've got Maw of the Void. It's not going to be that bad. You know, at the very worst, oh no, we'll just get a ton of, like, you know, full charges and just get our HP instantaneously back. It's hard to not be cocky about this run just because of how many advantages we have in the defense apartment. Department and the apartment. What would a defense apartment look like? It'd probably look like my old college apartment, probably. There'd be lots of Metallica posters. A couple things of a shake and bake that I forgot to put in the cupboard, but of course my girlfriend doesn't let me ever forget that. And in Counter-Strike 1.3 is playing on the tube. On the good old CRT. I mean, how many of you out there remember those kids? That's right. They weighed more than a standard baby. How much does a standard baby weigh? I have no idea. I don't have kids. I'm just going through the motion here. There's really nothing else for me to really say on this run. I mean, is it a good run? Yeah. You can't complain about a run that you can't lose. But if I had to complain about this run, it was just that we just need some freaking damage, man. Just give me a little bit of damage. I mean, you see here, like, Maw of the Void is like our godsend right now. And yes, Maw of the Void does spawn flies thanks to the mulligan. Strength card. Yeah, I don't need. We've got way too many full charges as it is for me to worry about HP anymore. Talk to me after we take this, you know, amazing deal with the devil here. Oh no, we got hit. He died anyway to global damage there. Yeah, we're just not gonna take the Book of Bilal. So go down the next floor. 33 minutes on a run that we can't lose. Oh, but we missed the Hush fight. Would I have fought Hush? Hell no. If you think this was taking a long time, just imagine how long a Hush fight would have taken. You don't even want to know. Now, Tammy's head brings up an interesting scenario here. If we do finally get a chance to get, you know, a good damage item that isn't Maw of the Void, that we can actually, like, utilize Tammy's head with, like, that would not be a bad combo. Obviously, you saw in that last run with the Brimstone Tammy's head, along with the a million of other ways that we could have won that run. Tammy's head, premier carry item in the game, as long as you have the tier effects. Honestly, the only tier effect that you need for Tammy's head to become the ultimate best item in the game, period, is, well, Death Touch or Brimstone. That's about it. I'm actually a little annoyed that Infamy stopped some damage there. Yeah, you know what, Chubb, I'm just going to let you do your thing, man. I'm going to be sitting here playing this Judgment. Whatever happens, happens. Nope. Come on, Judgment now. I'm making this, like, sarcastic quip so I can give you money and you're trying to blow yourself up. That's not good business practice, man. You're gonna blow yourself up. You're gonna blow yourself up out of a customer. I'm not gonna pay for this. You can't expect that level of service anywhere. It's just unrealistic. On top of that, it's probably borderline, you know, unhealthy. blowing yourself up seems as a suboptimal play for sure if you're trying to set up a business. You know, you're going to be... You talk about a one-trick pony. It's like, welcome to Fred's House of Frozen Groceries here. We've got everything. Hang on. To celebrate our momentous occasion of opening, let me first detonate this crock pot that I got here. Easy now. Guppy's tail is going to give us, you know, more chests. I mean, we quietly have 2 of 3 Guppy. And honestly, Guppy's not going to help us that much. Again, because we have literally no damage. Maw the Void is our best friend right now. There's a dice room. Would I re-roll this run? Yes. At this point, I'm willing to because of just how zany everything has been and the lack of, honestly, the real lack of, like, you know, interestingness on this run, which is not a run, which is not a word. I'm gonna say it is. I wouldn't mind it. Would it be possible for us to roll into something worse? Absolutely. Could we roll into a losable situation? Yes. Are we? Probably not. I don't know why I'm hell-bent on thinking that we're going to get a reroll. I just have a sneaky suspicion we're going to get a six room here. Nope. Oh, there's nothing new. Sorry, Keybagger. Again, suboptimal business strategy there. I mean, you get to go in and go out with a bang, for sure. People are going to remember it. You know, you're going to be telling the kids, hey, we went over to Bob's House of Frozen Groceries, and man, oh man, that was a spectacular grand opening. Really went out with a bang. This is why I'm not a comedian. I don't tell jokes. It's gonna be another two room. I mean, yeah, we could, you know, I could get the strike through. I forget what it's actually called, but it's basically just called no. And what that does is that greatly reduces the likelihood of any spacebar items dropping. You know, because that's not what we need right now. One aspect of this run that we do not need any help on is spacebar item, because let me tell you something, this spacebar item is not leaving our side. If the D100 shows up somehow, miraculously, even after taking no, would I re-roll the run? Yeah, I wouldn't re-run this run, but I would re-roll it again, just for the sake of something interesting. You know, the novelty of using our black soul hearts as offense is quickly worn off to the point where I'm just kind of like, oh man. Like I just kind of want to get. I want to get off the train now. Like, it's not. It's been a fun ride, you know. But where is the chase, and how quickly can we cut to it? Which I feel like would be like a really good pickup line for those of us who have no social skills whatsoever in the dating world. I'm not sure if I'm gonna impress too many girls by telling them that. Like, hey. I saw you over there at the box social last week. Don't ask me why it took me a week to talk to you, but I just wanted to know, where's the chase and how soon can we cut to it? So we're going to take Brimstone here because at this point, why not? We do have Tammy's head, which I am going to go back and get just to end the absurdity that has been this run. Now, I have no idea how much HP we have. And am I worried about that? You're funny. That's good. It's really good. Remember those, like, you know, 4,000 Hero Font cards that we had in the other room? Yeah. Don't worry. We'll be paying them a visit from good old Uncle Guppy here. We're not Guppy, but we might have a chance. I mean, we have a Joker card. So, once again, we end up getting Tammy said Brimstone, which I'm not going to poo-poo at all. I mean, that's, you know, there's a lot of things you don't want to do in Isaac, and one of them for sure is bite the hand that feeds, or in this case, bite the hand that gives you an unlosable run. So we could go back and get that get out of jail free card if we really wanted to crank up the absurdity level to 13 million, but I'm not going to do that. We're just going to end this run with our no damage having Brimstone, Tammy's head having, you know, circumstance here. Oh yeah, we don't have a charge on Tammy's head. That probably would have like helped a little bit. I was like, oh, we're just gonna walk in here and start our, you know, plow routine. That's this. Okay. We'll just do this then. I was gonna use our Joker card to save us the time, but why? Okay. Oh, man, you know, I don't even care anymore. Again, you can't say that a run like this isn't fun. I mean, it's a lot more fun now. I will admit it. This run got infinitely more interesting now that we've got Brimstone Tammy's head. But at the same time, there's, you know, it took us 39 minutes to get here. You know, if I sound a little ungrateful, that's me just being a terrible person. But at the same time, I think it's a little bit warranted that we didn't have like any damage to speak of until right at the very end. We did get Small Rock, which is going to help out our lack of damage because we're in such a terrible place now. Yeah, I mean, 24-hour energy is pretty good. You know, I'm still going to just use our Joker card. By 24, I meant 48-hour energy, of course. By the way, Key Beggars is going to start robbing us of all our keys, and that's fine, because honestly, I just don't care. We get the Pact, and we get Gimpy, which, sure, why not? And we get an Emperor card. Am I going to use the Emperor card? I'll use it for Isaac, but I'm not going to use it for Blue Baby. Because we might as well cash in our goodwill towards the game. Our little way of saying thank you for the bounties you have given us. I realized that I bombed that secret room and didn't even go in the secret room, and that's fine. You know what? Sometimes mistakes happen. You just got to roll with it. Just like good old Dan Giesling says, keep it hunted. I'm not a good Dan Giesling impersonator. Was there a curse room? Yes. Was there a secret room? Yes. Could we have gotten Guppy? Maybe. Do I care? Not really. Libra, that's going to be interesting considering that we have no stats. I don't know what this is going to do to us, and I don't care. I'm not going to take Taurus because that's basically going to be an all stats down. Our damage seems to be a little bit better. I don't think it could have possibly gotten any worse. And Mini Mush is going to be like pretty much an all stats up anyway. And let's just open up all these just because, you know, we might get keys and we might get chests. And you never know, we might actually get another Get Out of Jail Free card, which would be cool. Because if we ended up doing that, we could, you know, fight Mega Satan, which I would actually fight Mega Satan here. Judgment card, I mean, sure, why not? We'll just blow him up. And we get Sack Dagger, which is a fantastic item. Okay. Looking for that dad's key, or looking for that get out of jail free card. We get Tech Point 5, which is great. Super. Lard, no thank you. It's going to literally be an all stats down times a million. Well, not times a million, but you understand. I'm glad that we can't get a million in this game. That would be quite terrifying. Also, we got super duper small from Mini Mush and all the one that makes you smaller pills that we've taken, which has been all but like two, I think, plus the caffeine pill. Actually, I think we only took one all that makes you smaller pill. Look, it doesn't matter. I did not do nearly enough damage to this Dark One down here. I don't appreciate that at all, Dark One. I mean, I understand that you gotta live and everything, but you don't. What a compelling argument to make, like in a championship series of like a football match or like a basketball game, like, you know. I know you guys are trying to win and all, but don't. You can't. You're not allowed to. I don't think it's gonna fly at the country club next time you go golfing. Assuming that any of you out there play, you know, golf. Golf is one of those sports that I absolutely love playing, but I used to actually hate watching because I thought it was the most boring thing that's ever bored ever. But it is a lot of fun to play, and since playing, I think that, you know, watching the PGA's tour and stuff is actually not that bad. Now, is it something that I would sit down and watch all day? No. No, of course not. Don't be silly here. But, you know, is it great background audio for, you know, when you're having yourself, you know, a box social that you might need to tell someone when they need to cut to the chase and show it to you, that sort of thing? Yeah. Show the chase, by the way, is what I meant when I said show it to you. Freaking weirdos out there. This run has been over for the last 40 minutes. I just want to say that right now. I have completely checked out of this run and this commentary. It's, what time is it? It's 4:16 in the morning right now. I meant to go to bed at like 3 this morning, which is really early for me, for those of you who know me. And I ended up getting a run. I was like, yeah, you know, I can fit one more Isaac run in before calling it a day for today's workload. And boy, howdy. What a terrible experience it's been. Shame on you, game. Oh, yeah, you know, we'll just get, you know, Ludovico, because we needed a giant floating, you know, ball of death on top of our Tammy's head. You talk about playing X's and O's at the same time. Here you go. We're tick, tack, and toe. That's right. I made that reference. Count it. I mean, Stain died before he even knew, like, he was here. Does that make sense? Like Blue Baby is, like, nearly dead. And a great show, by the way, the lack of damage that we had. All right. Well, that was 44 minutes of fun. Thank you for watching, everyone. 49 minutes, whatever that said. I do appreciate it. Hey, we're moving on to 40. Getting very close now. So, again, if you enjoyed the series, please let me know down in the comments below. Like, favorite, all that kind of good stuff. It helps support me and your favorite content producers. We don't say it lightly. It actually does go a long way with supporting us. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Of course, see y'all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.